Hello friends, my name is Arun. Today I am going to discuss about searching techniques in Java. So in the previous video we have discussed about linear search or sequential search. But in this video I am going to discuss about binary search. So I'll discuss about the functionality of the binary search, how it will work. Okay. So the limitation of binary search is array element should be in a proper order. That means it may be in descending or it may be in ascending, and or it may be in ascending or it may be in descending. So it should be in order. Okay, otherwise what will be happened? Your bubble search will not be, I mean sorry, this binary search will not be work. Friends, let me take some few elements here. So what are the few elements? So n equal to number of elements. I am going to take 10 elements here. What are the 10 elements? Say 10, like 20, say 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Friends, I can take 5 elements and I can explain, but I want to explain in detail. That is the reason I am taking more elements, friends. And one more thing, assume that these 10 elements are already stored into the array. So what is the index of the 10? 0. 0. And what is the index of 20? 1. What is the index of 30? 2. And 3 here. 4. 5. 6. 7. And 8. Finally, 9, friends. Because, friends, this is the starting index. This is ending index, friends. So what I am doing is, I'll take some key value as well. What is the key value? Assume that first time I am taking 50. I am checking for whether 50 is available or not in the given list, friends. Okay. So for that one, what I am doing is I am taking two variables. What are those? Integer starting index equal to 0 and ending index equal to n minus 1. What is that? 9. Why, friends, I am taking n minus 1? Because I want to set this ending index at end of the array. That is the reason I have taken a equal to n minus 1. Friends, now what about si? Si is pointing here, friends. Si is pointing to this element, first element of the array. And what about the ei? Here, ei, what will be happen? 1 minute, friends. Let me take... Yeah, this is ending index, friends. So ending index equal to n minus 1, that is 9. So it is pointing to last element of the array. Now what I have to do? Nothing, friends. You have to find out middle index of the value. So how to find middle index of the array? So mi equal to, I know starting index value and I know ending index value. So please add both of them and by 2. So what is the value of si? 0. What is the value of ei? 9, friends, and by 2. What is the 9 by 2 value? 4, you will get it. And do you know, still if you are having any issues, please let me know here. And friends, what I am doing, how we are getting mi equal to 4, I am trying to explain you. I am dividing, 1 minute, friends, I am dividing 9 with 2, friends. So in 9, 2 how many times? 4 times. So 4 into 2, 8 we are getting. So the remainder is 1, friends. Okay, I will not bother about the remainder, but which operator I have used here? This is called quotient. For this one, which operator I have used? Division operator. So that is the reason mi equal to 4 you are getting. Okay, that's it, friends. Now what we need to do, you have to check if key equal to a of mi or not. So in linear search, what we did, we verified with the starting of the element. If it is not available, second element. If it is not available, third element. If it is not matched, fourth element. Like that we have verified. In this one, we are not verifying with top. We are not verifying from top to bottom, friends. So first we are finding the middle element. We are finding middle element and we are checking whether it is matched with the key element or not. If it is not available, then we'll check. If it is available, then you can say key element is found. Friends, in this case, what is the key element here? Key element is 50. equal to what about f? Mi is what is that? 4 friends. Okay, now 50 equal to what is a of 4 value? 50 friends. So both are same. What I can say? Element is found. Okay, this is first case friend. But you may ask, sir, if it is not 50, then what will be happened? That also we can discuss, friends. Now see here, this is first case. If the element is middle element, then this is the case. But if the key element is also not 50, then I am taking key element equal to say 20. Key equal to 20, then what will be happened? Starting index is 0 and ending index also 9. No problem. Then you have to find out middle index value. How to find middle index? So starting index plus ending index by 2. So what is the starting index, friends? 0 plus 9 by 2. How much? 9 by 2. You will get 4, friends. So just now we have discussed how we got 4. Okay. Now what I will check, I have to check what is the condition here. If key equal to a of mi or not. So what about key value? Key value is 20. Now I am looking for a of mi. What is a of mi? Is what is that? 4 here, friends. And 20 equal to a of 4 is how much? 50. This is, friends, a of 4 means this one. Okay, now I mean, it is 20 equal to 50. Is it correct? No, right? So element is not matched with the middle index. So then we can say element is, we cannot say like middle element is not matching with our key element. Then what will be happen, friends? No problem. Then you have to split the entire list into two parts, friends. So this part is called, name it, friends. You can give any name. Just I am saying that this is called upper deck. Okay, and this part is called lower deck. And currently, what are the values? SI equal to 0 and ending index is 0. Sorry, ending index is 9. And what about the MI value? MI is pointing to here, friends, 4. Now, please let me know if the key is 20, in which part, I mean, in which deck value will be available? Damn sure in upper deck, right? So no need to check in the lower deck. So that is the reason in binary search element should be in a sorting order. Okay, now let me take what we have to do. You have to check by using AFMI. We can decide key element is available in upper deck or lower deck. So for that one, what we are doing is, if key is less than AFMI. So what is the key value? 20 is less than, what is a of mi? a of 4 means 50. Yes, 20 is less than 50 means definitely value is available in the upper deck only. In this case, what I am doing here, I am not changing the position of the SI. Just I am moving ending index to mi minus 1. See, friends, what I am doing here? Very simple thing. Ending index will become up. Ending index equal to, you can take mi, but already we verified, right? That is the reason I'm checking mi in front. So already we have verified 50, right? So no need to check 50 again. That is the reason we are skipping 50 and we are taking mi minus 1. Now what is the position of the ending index? Previously it was pointing to a last value. Now see here what will be happen. This is a. Now, here is what is that? Mi minus 1. What is mi value? 4 minus 1. It is 3, friends. Okay. Now, it is pointing to here. Okay. So, forget about all these things. No need to check these values. Now, what will be happen, friends? See here. Again, I'll check same condition here. What is the condition? If like key equal to a of mi or not, I'll check. What is the key value, friends? 20 I am looking. And a of mi, what is the a of mi value? Sorry, friends, I did not calculate it. You have to calculate it. So mi equal to, what is that? Si plus ei by 2. What is the si value? 0 plus ei. Ei value has been changed to 3, not 9, friends. It is 3. Be careful. And by 2, what is the 3 by 2? How much? 1, you will get it. So what about a of mi? Say a of mi means 1 only, friends. Okay, now what about this value 20 equal to a of 1? How much? 20. Value is both are, if key value and a of mi both are matches. So definitely you can say element found. Okay, and assume that if key is not 20, if the key is some 100 or 90, then what will be happened? So key is less than a of mi, value will be, I mean, this condition will be failed here. In this case, what will be happened? No need to check the element, key element in the upper part. We have to check in the lower part. In that case, what will be happened? Ending index value will not be changed, friends. Starting index value will be changed. So what we need to do here? Now we have to change the SI value equal to MI plus 1. That's it. Why MI plus 1? Already 50. Already we have checked. So no need to check 50. So move to next position. That is the reason MI plus 1 I am doing. And we have to repeat these steps till values matched actually. And till how many times we have to do this one? Only simple one condition, friends. SI is coming from top to bottom and ending index is coming from bottom to top. Once both are crossed each other, you can say cross each other, no need to check coming out, and simply element is not found. So that is the logic I am going to implement, friends. And still, if you are not understanding, please let me know in the comment section, friends. I'll explain in a better manner. I'll try to explain in a better manner, and I'll do a separate video on that. And one more thing, friends. It's a bit important one, and not only for freshers. If you are having 5 years, or even if you are having 10 years of experience, also interview persons are asking this type of questions to write the logic. So many people are failing. Maybe they conceptually they may be very strong, but logical programming, logic maybe will not strike at that moment. So please be prepared, friends. It will be very helpful. And I'm trying to implement the logic, friends. It's very simple if you try to understand the concept. So already I have taken one class. The name of the class is binary search. In that already I have taken one main method, and I created one object for scanner class, and I'm trying to display one message on the screen, and I read number of elements from the keyboard, and I created one array as well. That's it. Now I'm trying to read the array elements. So enter array elements. So how to read? You have to take for loop. It's not a single value, right? That is the reason I am taking for loop here. So integer array index starting from 0 and I less than or equal to n minus 1 you can take, or n also you can take it. I plus plus, friends. Now how to read a of I equal to sc dot next in, friends. Friends, how to read array values, if you are having any confusion, any issues, please let me know in the comment section. I'll make a separate video on that. I'm assuming that you know very well how to read this array values. There is a reason I'm skipping that part, and directly I'm implementing my logic, friends. And once, so far what happened, I read number of values, I read array elements, and one more thing you have to read from the keyboard. What is that? What is the key element or searching elements? And you have to put into R X R key, anything you can take it. Just I am taking X, and save this program, friends, and come down. What we need to do, you have to take two variables, say integer SI equal to 0 and EI equal to n minus 1. Why SI equal to 0 means what will be happening initially? SI starting index is it is pointing to the first element. EI equal to n minus 1 means EI is pointing to the last element. That's it, friends. And I am taking one while loop. I don't know how many iterations I have to do. That is the reason I am taking while loop here. And here SI is less than or equal to EI. That means both pointers should not be cross each other. Once cross each other means the value is not, element is not available, friends. Element is not found. Okay, that is the reason SI less than or equal to EI I am doing. One more thing, friends. SI is coming from top to bottom, and ending index is coming from bottom to top. So once both are crossed each other means value is not available. And what I am doing, I am finding MI value, middle index, friends. Okay, I know starting position, I know ending index position, you know midpoint, right? So it's very simple. How to SI plus EI by 2, you can take it. Okay, now friends, And what I need to do? You have to check if condition. What is the if? I mean, where is the key element or searching element in inside the x? So x equal to, I am checking a of mi. Mi is index and a of mi is the middle element. Friends, please don't get confused here. Mi is index and a of mi is element. Okay, both are different. So if x equal to a of mi, definitely I can say what that element is available. But what I am doing, I'm not displaying the message here. I am taking one flag value. What is initially I have taken false, and come here and flag equal to true. I am taking friends, and you have to specify the flag type. What is the data type here? Boolean I am using. You may take anything. Okay. Once element is available, there is no, it's not required to check remaining elements as well. So that is the reason I am taking break, and that's it friends. So if the element is not available, then what will be happen? I am dividing the entire list into two parts. What are those? Upper part and lower part. So I have to check element is available, key element is available in the upper part or lower part. By using a of mi, I can decide how. See friends, if x is less than a of mi, that means if key element is less than the middle value, then what I need to do here? You have to change ending index is equal to mi minus 1. Okay, else means, what is the meaning of else? X is not less than friends, x is greater than middle index. So value will be available in the lower deck. In that case, starting index equal to mi plus 1 friends. That's it friends. And no need to do anything. Automatically this while loop will be executed till value will be available or not. Okay, how to check whether value is, element is available or not? Very simple. You have to check the, flag value. So anyway, flag is Boolean value. It contains false or true. If it is true, that definitely you can say system.out.println element is available. Element found. Yes, what I need to do? You can directly display element not found. Element not found. And one more thing friends, if you want position of the element, in which position key element is found, nothing friends, very simple. You can take integer some position equal to 0, or else p also you can take it. So where I need to do, if the flag equal to true, then p equal to, say 1 minute, p equal to which one you have to pass? Mi value, you can pass it. That's it friends. And come out, that's it. Let me execute it friends, whether my logic is working fine or not. Yes, how many elements you want? Just I want 5 elements. What are those? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 friends. And the under key element are searching element. I am looking for 50. Element is available or not? Element found. And one more thing friends, and how many elements you want? One friends. How many element? 1 minute. Not element, elements friends. And save this program. And please execute. Let me execute once again. How many elements you want? I want say 5. What are those? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So 50, 60. I'm looking for 60. 60 is not available friends. And that's it friends. And if you still need any help from me, please let me know in the comment section friends. Definitely I'll help you with your assignments. And thanks a lot friends. In the next video we'll discuss about sorting techniques. Like, we have various sorting techniques. What are those? Bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, quick sort, heap sort, midge sort. So many sorting techniques are there. So I'll make separate video on that friends, and in the next video I will do that one. Okay, thanks a lot friends. Thanks a lot for watching my video.